MrExcel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Excel in depth, chapter 36, page layout view. Well, you know, I always joke with Excel 2007, they said all of the commands will always, always, always be at the top of the screen. Every command at the top of the screen, you'll never have to look for floating commands, except these three commands at the bottom. Okay, and you might remember something called page break preview mode, page break preview in Excel 2003. This weird thing with the blue lines that showed where the page breaks were going to be. I was never a fan of that. It used to just take up a lot of memory. What is really new, though, here in Excel 2007 and Excel 2010 is page layout view. I have to tell you, I really like page layout view because it shows me my worksheet. It shows me where the margins are going to be. It shows me where the headers and footers are going to be. And if I scroll outside the used region, I can still keep adding more data. I'm not... it's not like it's grayed out there. It welcomes me to add more data. A few things you can do, you see that there's three zones up here for header, and then three zones at the bottom for footers, and you can click in any of those to edit. When you do that, you're going to get a brand new tab, the header footer tab. So this offers a variety of canned headers, or you can build your own as before. All right, so page layout view, brand new in Excel 2010. If you're looking up here, you know, in the ribbon, it's there under view, but it's always available with these three icons down at the bottom. The first one is normal, second one page layout, third one the old page break preview. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.